across to Bombay now. We've got Chanda Kochar, head of ICICI. Thank you very much, Chanda Kochar, for joining us. First reactions to the budget, the main highlights, 2-3 points you think were good and 2-3 points that disappoint you.
2-3 points that I think were good was, first of all, it's talking of, you know, targeting a 9% growth. So I think that itself is a very bold and a positive mood to say that we'll target a 9% growth. The other good point is that it's a budget that is again going to further strengthen domestic consumption. So many things that could be done to leave the purchasing power in the hands of the people, that has been done. And we've realized in the last 1 year that domestic consumption has been the mainstay of our economy. So that's the other positive point. I would think the third positive point is the fact that on taxes, actually there seems to be a reform agenda. So one, you know, he's probably given whatever he could. And he's also identified that there is a reform agenda. We've done away with FBT, we are talking of GST and so on. So there's a move in the right direction. But things that are, I guess, missing or which could have got more clarity is where is all the money going to come from? I'm actually not particularly disturbed by the fiscal deficit number of 6.8%. I think as long as we spend the money in the right direction, it's only going to fuel consumption and investment. But what is today important is for all of us to know how we are going to manage that money. There is again a lot of money that can be made available in the form of disinvestment, but the budget lacked clarity in terms of clarifying how much are we planning to raise out of disinvestment. I think had we clarified that, a lot of worries of the market would have probably gone away. Secondly, in fact, the second point that leads from disinvestment is the fact that once we know how much we are going to raise from disinvestment, we could get a better idea of how much of more government borrowings are going to come into the market. And today we must realize that the entire yields on Government of India securities are not correcting because there's a huge amount of uncertainty in terms of how much government borrowings is going to be made available in the market. And had we clarified the entire government borrowing program, I think that would have again taken off a lot of uncertainty.
Chanda, if you could just explain that a little bit, because it's a bit technical. They've got this huge budget deficit. They're obviously going to have to raise money from the market. But you're saying it's not clear how they're going to do it, whether it's going to be under RBI supervision, what's going to happen to interest rates, all that. Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying that we could actually clarify a little bit more. Today, the market is really reeling under the uncertainty of how much of the supply of this Government of India securities is going to hit the market. What is important is not really to reduce the amount or increase the amount or whatever. What is first most important is to give a clarity on that. So if we are saying the fiscal deficit is going to be 6.8%, we need money to fuel consumption and investment. I think these are using money to fuel consumption and investment is a very good direction. But first of all, large part of this money can also be met or the gap can be met by disinvestment. So first we should clarify what is the target for disinvestment? So right. The market knows that X amount of money will come out of disinvestment.